Welcome back for a brand new video. Dario Ortiz here with you again one more time, bringing you some more new features of our software karate tournament system version 1.7. It feels like a while, like we've been out for a while, but we've been working really hard on the software. So far, I want to give you a quick preview of all the new things we have worked on the new version. We created a new version, as you can see, the version 1.7. Having worked hard on the software, it's amazing the response we have had from the karate community. We already have our software running on over 30 countries around the world. Amazing. We are so happy. I can't believe we have achieved this amount of countries and dojos and people using our software to do their tournaments. Incredible. We have received a lot of feedback because of that. And we have added a lot of amazing features based on a lot of requests we have received through email of new things that they would like that the software had. And we have incorporated almost everything we have received, the majority of it. We're gonna divide this video in two parts because it's a lot of material we have added since the first version of our software. And we're gonna go through them as quick as we can, because if you wanna really go into detail, the software is still runs the same way that we designed it the first time. We just added a lot of new features and enhancements that our users has been asking for. So thank you for all the support you have given us with our software. And thank you for using our software. Remember, we gave it for free for this full year of the COVID. And it's been amazing. The response has been amazing. And we hope the software can keep on helping you on your tournaments, and that we could meet your expectations in within the quality and the features that our software has in order to help you out. Okay, so one more time, let's start with the software and let's go quickly to the new features that we have. The first thing you're gonna notice once you open your software for the first time again is that we change our toolbar. We reduced the amount of features you used to see on top of the toolbar, and we created new menus because it's now so much features in it that we think it was too crowded. So we created a more sophisticated and more simplified UI. So the first thing we got to know is that when we go to file, we're going to get in our files, we're going to get our general information. In general information, we're gonna get the dojo information, the divisions information, categories, everything that we are used to looking for, there's gonna be here to fill out our software in order for it to run. One of the new features you're gonna see here is the flags. You didn't have this feature before. And what this feature does is it creates a list of country and flags that are going to be now appearing on your scoreboard. Okay, so now when your competitor competes, you're gonna be able to pick a flag for each competitor when you register him, and that flag will show automatically on the scoreboard once the competitor comes up. And we'll see that feature working. We'll bring it up so you can see it. But here's where you set up those flags, and here's where you set all that information right there. Another new feature that has been asked for a couple of emails that we received was that we had a little problem with the pictures. We envisioned that, you know, the pictures was gonna be something simple that people could just get a picture and put it in, and that was gonna be about it. But then everybody told us that it was and it was true. It's a lot of different ways of bringing those pictures into the software that creates a lot of different situations. Like, for example, you could bring a picture in through a camera. You could bring a picture in through a scanner. You could bring a picture in straight from Facebook. You could bring a picture in straight from an email that the person sends you. And then that same picture could come in a lot of different resolutions and a lot of different sizes. It could come turn around. It could come flipped. It could come in a lot of different ways that in order for you to integrate the picture onto the competitor part of the software, it was becoming a little bit of a little bit hard for our users. So they asked if we could find a way to help them out to manage those pictures. So we created a whole software that will help you with the setting up and preparing of those pictures. Because another feature you're going to see that we added on the software is just not the pictures of the competitors now. Now we also added on the software a feature so that you could add on the record of the competitor, you can also add a copy of his passport, trip or flying ticket, maybe license, driver's license, any type of information that you want to scan regarding that competitor. We created a module, an additional module on the competitor's area that allows you to store that information on his record. So this module becomes very important, the picture module, because now this module will allow you to edit, cut, paste any picture coming from anywhere. Because before it used to be that you had to scan all this information. Today and days, you could just take a cellular phone and just take a picture, boom, 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 of each one of these identifications and bring it into the computer. You could just even use the camera of your laptop, you know, like you put it in front of the camera and you just take that picture, snap it, bloop, and you want to put it into the record, you're going to be able to do all that. And we're going to show you how we added on the software features for you to do that. If you go through the rest is just the same information for the league information, federal information, how to create the information for the technicals, the people that are going to be the staff that's going to be working on the tournament. All the rest information is still there. So we're going to go through this, but not now. We first want to get a quick overview of everything that has been added that is out here. And then we're going to go inside each one of those features. We're going to work on them. You get here the two historicals. Remember, history is very important and allows you to store the most important information of each tournament once you reset the tournament. So remember, when you use your software, you're going to reset it so that all the information of the last tournament goes away and you start with a clean slate. But when you do that, you don't want to lose information maybe of people that paid, people that won, all these different things. And this historical only stores the most important information of each tournament so that you can have a historical database of that information. And that way you don't lose every information of every tournament you have. Then we go from here to edit. It's the same information. Then we go to the tournament info. This area has changed a lot. Even though it looks simple, the changes that you're going to see, the insides of this area has been recoded to a higher level. Now, you're going to create your tournaments, and once you create them, you're going to be able to say this tournament is the active tournament. And that's going to be a very important thing, because when you create the active tournament, what that's going to do is it's going to allow you to set that tournament as the tournament that is being run at the moment. And what that will do is it will go to all the screens of the software and all the areas of browsers and searches of the software and tell them, listen, I want you to list only the persons that are active for this tournament. This is a very important feature because this will allow you to have thousands of competitors register, but only see at the time of registration or setting up for a tournament competition competitors that are active for this tournament. That I mean, when I mean active, that they paid, you for your tournament, or that you decide to make them active even though they didn't pay, but that you decide that they are active for that tournament. That way you don't have to search within the thousands and thousands of competitors that you might eventually have if everybody starts registering on your software and you start storing all that information in your database. And you're gonna see how that works. So this area has been redesigned so that it allows you to do that. Then you're gonna go to the, this area is gonna be amazing. This is the registration competitors area. This also has been redesigned, and now we added in there some very incredible features. Like for example, when you reset your tournament, it's necessary for you to erase all the information of the previous tournaments. But one of the things that happened in some people that did tournaments with us, with the software, is that by accident, I don't know how, because the software gives you two warnings before you erase, but by accident, they erased the information of the tournament that was running currently. And they had to like re-enter everything, and that was really sad. So we created more safeguards now. So now you could reset your tournament and get your software totally blank, clean slate, so that you could start an event. But the software now creates, and you're gonna see how it does it, a backup directory straight in your folders directory, which is will store a backup of everything that is in your tournament right before it deletes it. And even backups a little bit more than just the active tournament information. It actually does a backup of a full backup of the whole database of the software. So if by any accident you delete the tournament by clicking to reset the tournament, it could be totally restored to the original state that it was when they clicked that button. That's very important, because they asked us for that feature and we created that feature so that it could be a safeguard for any accident. And it is a very deep feature, because the way we created that feature, even if the person does it two or three times, like let's say he by accident did, I don't know what, maybe he clicked it three times, the button, I don't know, and it erased it, the software, three times, it really doesn't matter, because the software will create a backup of each instance that he clicks that button. So even if he erased the software five times, you could still go to the first time he deleted and bring all the data back. Because obviously, remember, if he erases it the first time, all the data that was there will go to the backup directory. But the second time he deletes it, it is nothing to be deleted. So it will store a empty database on those backups. And if you do it three or four times, there will be empty backups, because in this case, the software was totally empty anyways. So that's why we created this feature that allows you to create several backups with different times and dates, so that if by any mistake happens, you can still go back. And this is a nice feature anyway, because it allows you, if you erased your software and maybe you're running your fifth tournament of the year, and you want to go to the first tournament of the year and you want to look some information of that tournament, this will also allow you to do that. So it's a very nice feature to have if it is necessary. And it was added on this new version 1.7. Another feature we added on this version of the 1.7 was the fault tolerance feature. This is amazing. This was another thing that came up with some of the tournaments that they've been calling us and they've been doing. And it is, okay, one problem that some people had in some tournaments was somebody by accident, or maybe problems with the cabling, something, they turn off the server, the machine that is running the tournaments, the master computer. So all the stations will go down automatically because they're connected to that main station. So if the cable broke, if the light went out, if the battery went down of that computer, well, all the stations will start going down. So all your tatamis will start going down because they don't have connection to the main computer again. So we created a fault tolerance feature, and it works very simple, and we'll show you all the ways you could implement this feature, all the steps you got to do. And it's very simple. It's a button that you click, and what it does is it creates a folder with the information of the tournament. So let's say you got your tournament all set up, everything is ready, time is up. Okay, it's time to start the tournament. Everybody's registered. We're live. We're going live. So right before you go live, you're gonna click this button. This button will create you a folder that you will copy on each one of the stations that are running the tournament system, and will allow them to run as standalones connected to a server, so that if the server goes down, they still keep working and they don't need the server in order to finish the tournament if an emergency like that would happen. If the server is still working and you create a very robust network that does not have the possibility of failure, well, then it's no problem. You won't probably need this fault tolerance. But you know how it is, you know, when you do tournaments, you get, you know, if you bought brand new laptops and you got state-of-the-art routers and wiring and all that, everything will run fine and beautiful, right? But sometimes you get the laptop that was in the dojo, in the corner, in a closet, and it might not be in the tip-top shape. And then the computer might have viruses, it might start freezing, and that's a disaster just waiting to happen. So this will allow you to keep those stations running even if you get a problem on your end of the server or the computer that is the main computer. So we'll see those features once we go to there. Then we got this area, it's the Kumite and Kata area. We consolidated all the new screens on these sports, on these two different drop downs. So now you got the individual Kumite here, and then you got the elite Kumite here, and here you got a simple scoreboard. And just a quick overview, all these have been redesigned, and the features that we added in here are amazing. We created algorithms that are state of the art in order to get random competitors matched together in a competition without needing a manual intervention. And let me see if I can explain that in a quick way. So we added features in here, like for example, now when you pick your competitors and you say pick them randomly, it'll go to the category of those competitors and it will go and pick each one of the competitors and it will put them randomly on the scoreboard, making sure that it does not match two bi competitors or two non-competitors together. It also makes sure that it doesn't match two from the same dojo together, and it creates a algorithm that allows you to, after the selection is done, it allows you to manually change any additional change you want to do to that chart that has been automatically picked. And that's very important, because when you go to a tournament, if the system does the random competitor setup, and by any chance, like for example, remember, it could pick from different dojos, but remember, if one dojo has 10 competitors and all the other dojos are only 1s and 2s, sooner or later from the same dojo will be matchups. They will match up because it is just no physical way to match them. It's too many competitors from a different dojo, from a same dojo, and too little competitors from different dojos. So it's not enough competitors to match up. So it will eventually have to match up from the same dojo. So if you wanted to change any of those, it will still allow you to do that. So it gives you an amazing power at the time to matching up your competitors randomly, and at the same time combining it with a setup that is in the order of manual slash random. And we did that for all the keys. We did it for the four competitor keys. We did it for the eight competitors key. We did it for the 16 competitors key. And we also did it for the elite version of the software. We also did that. And when we go here, another feature you're gonna see here is that we added the ability now to do a full screen of the scoreboard. This was asked a lot because before we would show the scoreboard in a little screen, and some people had monitors huge, you know, like 70 inches, 60 inches. You know, we were used to using monitors of 31 inches, small monitors. And now we're talking about humongous monitors in order to show these points. So now the software allows you to full screen to those different sizes of monitors, at least to cover the area. And we fixed that a little in order to get those requests fulfilled. Another thing we added on the software now is called a simple scoreboard, okay? We had this software sold separately, but we also added it in to the full version of the software now. So it will be part of the full version of the software, and also you could get it separately. What this does is now it's gonna allow you, let's say you don't wanna go, this is a last fight maybe, or maybe you're just doing four or five fights, simple fights, where you don't wanna go through registrations, you don't wanna go through signing in competitors, you just want a simple scoreboard so that you could do a quick fight and get it over with and go home. This will allow you to do that. A simple scoreboard that allows you only to put the competitors and just give start points, see the timing running, everything like if it was in the full system, but not integrated on the full system. As a just simple, the word says it, simple scoreboard. It just lets you do a simple scoreboard event. Then in the kata area, we got all the competitors on the kata area, and we added amazing features. People were asking us if we could show like graphical representations of the competitors when they won, when they lose, when they got points on their different kata evaluations. And we went overboard with this. We created charts and bars, and now you can see a lot of different representation of the competitors in graphical representation of their scores, and that gives you a more visual look of how's it going in the competition and all that. That's amazing, and it's working beautiful. Plus, we did that also with the weapons area. We also did it with the weapons area, so it also shows a lot of these features. Then we go to the kumite and team kumite area and kata, and what we did here is amazing. We added a whole new module for team competition. So now what you get is a new area so that, okay, I wanna have my competitors compete in kumite, in team, beautiful. You could do it in teams of four, teams of three, but then you get now a new area for teams of three competition in kata. And this could this creates a new area of the sport for you and for your tournaments. So now what you could do with this module is you could have, for example, three teams of five competitors each that wants to compete in kata. And these competitors will compete and they will get scores in points. And those points The regular points that the judges give when they do an evaluation of a kata WKF style, they would get this, those points written in their final scores. And at the end of that match, the team that gets more points wins and goes against the other team. And at the end of the day, once the all the competitions are done, you're going to get a first team first spot, a second team second spot, and a third team third spot for a competition of kata of five competitors each on each competition. And it's very fun for the competitors. They compete in kata, you know. Sometimes you get tournaments where you get a lot of competitors that you get two or three or four elites that get all the medals, and then nobody else gets medals, and it is not fun for the people that don't get medals. Now you get a tournament where you could have these elites mix with some of their greatest students of their dojos and be able to compete, right? Against other dojos where they get some of their elites, but some of their regular students. And now everybody gets a chance to compete in a winning team. And this is a very fun area, and it's going to be very fun for your dojos when they use it for competition. I hope you like it. It was requested, and we designed it specifically for the request that we got. And we tested it. It works beautiful. I hope you like it. And it also has the feature added that allows you to show the ready up competitors, which is for the other areas of the software, they're standard. On this, we had to add it, and we added in. So now you also can use the ready up competitors display scoreboard, display board, so that you could show to your students while they're getting ready up, so that they don't have to have a little board or a little person calling saying, listen, you got to get ready, it's your turn. Now they could look at the screen and see that they're ready for competition. That's in this area. And then the last but not least is the cues. They keep doing the same thing in the area of the external scoreboards. We added in there the feature that I just told you that allows you now to maximize all these scoreboards so that you could show them in external monitors and they fill up the whole screen. That took us a little while, but we got it done. And this is the regular area of the regular scoreboard. We also helped here in this area creating the judges setup for security, so that when you're going to use the scorecards for judges, we created it automatically so that you didn't have to do it over there, because it was a little bit overwhelming for the users to create these judges and set them up. So we did that for you, and now it's part of the software. We include the setup of the judges just right there, so you don't have to go through it. So what I just did right now was give you a quick overview of all the features that we went through the software and that we got done. So if you just heard what I said, you could probably go and play with everything and try to get it to work and try to understand it. If you don't, we're going to have now a second part of the video. I want to give a break here so you could take some time and relax and then go through the other videos. And we're going to take each one of these areas now, and we're going to do a little video for each one of them so that you could go and review all these new features that were added to the version 7.1. Remember, if you have any other suggestions or any other features you would like to see on the software, make sure you send it to our email. If you want to see our information, you could just go here in the file in About Us, and all our information is right here, okay? You get our phone number if you want to just call us direct. You get our emails if you just want to send us an email. We just get your emails. We got a lot of emails because this is the thing. It's about 30 countries around the world, and we have countries like Egypt, Israel. We have a lot of countries from the Middle East and all the areas, and we don't really speak those languages. We even have it in Japan. I don't talk a lot of Japanese. I know Japanese words and a couple of sentences, but I'm not like to really get down to a full conversation fluid. And we got a lot of countries that are different from ours, like Brazil and all that. And what we've been doing is they've been sending us email, and it's a little bit easier for us to work with it because we could just translate it. And it's very easy like that. Google help us and all that. So if you see any other feature that you think you will like to see on the software and it isn't within our power to get it done, we will work on it and we'll try to have it there so that for the next year when the software goes live, we have all these new features and amazing features there for you to use. Even though it's a lot of people that we didn't thought it was gonna happen, but it did happen. A lot of people started doing tournaments again, and it looks like this year is going to be a very nice year for starting tournaments and running tournaments. We are starting our tournaments here in Puerto Rico also, and we have run a few already, so it's been fun for us too. I hope you enjoy the software, and if you have any other questions or any little detail that you want to let us know, make sure to contact us, and we'll gladly take your call and help you out on anything we need, we can help you out. Remember, use our tutorials. All the videos we're preparing are tutorials, full hands-on, that shows you detail by detail how to do every single change on the software and understand the software in the full manner of the software. So, with no more, thank you for your time, and let's see you in the next video. Bye-bye.